Welcome to this current affair topic that will take SAARC and SICA. How these two groups are beneficial for the world, with respect to India, with respect to Asia. What are the problems or the hurdles in the SAARC? How the Pakistan is creating issue with the India in the development, in the success of the SAARC group. How India is approaching SAARC minus Pakistan agenda. We will see all these issues in this lecture moving ahead. So, what exactly is SAARC? Which countries are the part of the SAARC nations? So, all the the neighbors of the India we will see as a member of SAARC. So, these are Nepal, Afghanistan, you will see Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Sri Lanka and Pakistan. Okay, so these are the members of the SAARC. Now, the issue with this group of the SAARC nations that Pakistan is creating a problem with the India in the development, in the success of any missions through this group. The issue with the Pakistan is only the Kashmir issue. They only want Kashmir issues. Whatever the issues, whatever the agenda was put in front of the SAARC nations, Pakistan is creating a hurdle, like they put the agenda of Kashmir issues. Kashmir is an integral part of India. So it is a discussion with the India only. It is an internal affair of the India, but Pakistan is pushing their hand in the Indian internal part of Kashmir as a union territory. Okay, so India and the surrounding neighbors, as a member of SAARC, it was established in the 1985, and India was also a founding member in the formation of SAARC. So expanding regional mechanism with respect to, it was the main motive for the introduction of the SAARC grouping, was that to introduce the regional mechanism with respect to, they want open trade, transport, people to people contacting, tourism, that will be much prosperous through this SAARC grouping. So that was the main motive, to make the tourism, to give the economical economical benefit from the introduction by the motivating or by the advertisements of all the tourism and all, and it should be from the different countries. Okay, so this was the main motive for the introduction of the SAARC nation. Okay, so but many a times it became non-functional. SAARC has become non-functional only because of what? Only because of this Pakistan. The India and Pakistan had a bad relation, and which ultimately affect this SAARC group. How is this affecting? Let us see. See, the major aim of SAARC was to provide the transportation linkage to all the South Asian nations. So if you see in the European part, you will see that all the nations have a very good connectivity between them. Irrespective of lots of war happened between those countries, but they have the good connectivity. With respect to South Asian nations, we don't have such issues. We don't have such kind of wars within us. But ultimately also, we don't have a good transportation linkage with those nations. A transportation agreement is required, but due to insistence of Pakistan on Kashmir issue, India and Pakistan never had a fruitful discussion and emerged as a major hurdle for such agreement. And South Asia is the least connected themselves in the world. As I've said that in Europe, they had more wars than us. We don't have such kind of wars, but still we don't have a good connectivity like Europe. Europe had a more wars, but the people can move freely in the Europe. So what is the way forward for this SAARC issue? Way forward is that India is demanding for grouping for the SAARC as a SAARC minus Pakistan. That India is claiming that we should not include Pakistan in this grouping. Now we should form a grouping of SAARC as a SAARC minus Pakistan, then only we can be able to achieve our all the aims, and we will get economical benefit for all those countries, not with respect to India, with all those countries. Okay, so it want to ensure more and more people contact and then travel between the countries. Tourism will be evolved. Okay, so it will significantly better the relationship between the neighboring countries. Present ruling government has the policy Modi government has the policy neighborhood first. Every time neighborhood first. When the earthquake happened in the Nepal, Indian Prime Minister first sent all the relief measures to the country. Similarly, in the COVID time also, India has launched various initiatives for the SAARC nations like COVID-19 Emergency Fund, COVID-19 Information Platform, COINEX, that is in the short form of the COINEX, then operationalization of the SAARC Emergency Fund, then SAARC Food Bank Mechanism, and also India is showing too interest in this world. India is proving like he is working hard to normalize the SAARC nations. That's why we will see in the future, we will achieve SAARC minus Pakistan motive. As the other countries, excluding SAARC, they are watching that India is actually working hard. And India is investing to help those nations present in the SAARC too. So that's why in future, we may achieve SAARC as a SAARC minus Pakistan. Okay, this was from the SAARC view. So moving ahead with the SICA one. What is SICA? SICA is nothing but conference on international and confidence building measures in Asia. Okay, it is nothing but it is a unified body or organizations deal interact with the conversation aspect of the negotiation to sort out various problems of Asia. So it is respectively with connected with the Asia. What are the problems like we have to introduce for the peace and negotiations, promoting peace and cooperations within the Asia. It has that motive. Okay, so the idea of SICA was given by the Nur Sultan Nazarbayev, that is the president of Kazakhstan in 1992. He was the founding father of the SICA. So the Conference on Interaction and Confidence that Building Measures in Asia is an intergovernmental forum for enhancing cooperation towards promoting peace, security and stability in India. Okay, so the main motives in the SAARC one, the main motive was to provide connectivity to all the South Asian nations and so that the trade, tourism and all will increase. Similarly, in the SICA, they have the aim of promoting towards peace, security and stability in Asia. So in this also, if we more define these terms, we will see that trades and all are coming in those definitions. Okay, so Asian countries have their own set of problems. We can't compare the problems of Asian countries with the European and all. See why? It is because we have another set of problems compared with the Western world. So presence of because these Asian countries have lots of ethnic groups, too much diversity is present in these Asian countries. In India only we will see too much diversity, and another no country such that much diverse as India, but other countries are all too diverse in this Asia. So presence of different ethnic groups that is complicated cultural in each country. So there is a need of a common platform. We can't compare with our countries with the Western world. We can't compare our group organization. We can't make our organization or the countries of the Asia to work on the platform of the Western countries. We should have our separate organization or a group for the Asian countries because of that diversity we have. So there is a need of common platform for Asia to resolve such issues. And the first summit that was held with this SICA was in the 4th June 2002 as a platform for conflict resolution in Asian way. In what? In Asian way. Okay. So it consists of the total member in the SICA is around 27 member nations from Asia, including Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Cambodia, China, Egypt and India and all. And Japan, Indonesia, USA type of countries are acting as a observer nations. Okay. So it is also around 5, I think, observer nations was there. I'm not sure. So the Republic of Tajikistan is the SICA, that is the chairman of this period, that is the 2018 to 2020. that is the Tajikistan is the chairman of this period. So this was something related to Sika. So in the exams also it will not be asked like what kind of member is in the in this group and all. It will be completely dependent upon the current affair topic. So if this Sika is in news in the year, in the respective year of your exam, then the question might come. There is a great probability of, there is a high probability of coming of the question from the Sika. Which countries are acting as the observer one, which country as which countries are the members and all. No need to remember all those 27 members or the observer nations and all. Okay, that's why just keep connected with the current affair topics. So that's what's in this lecture. I hope you have understand all those things better. Please like and subscribe. Your subscription is a form of payment you are making me. This is a new channel. Okay, so if you have any suggestions, if you want any on-demand video lecture, please feel free to ping on my Twitter handle. Thank you.